Okay, we're going to be doing something a little bit different with this video. It's going to pick up at the point where you have a drop-down list in Google Sheets, but you can't figure out how to get it to allow more than one selection at a time. So this video will give you three different options, give multiple selections. They can choose zero, they can choose one, they can choose more than one. And after they select them, it will put the values into the cell. It's not going to do it in their traditional drop-down list, but you can't do that. So I'm hoping that one of these solutions will work for you. Check it out. So this first option is one that I found online, and it uses the built-in flexibility of Google Sheets to run a custom script. And I'll have this in the description of the video. And I open this link in a new tab. It's going to ask if I want to bring this spreadsheet into my Google Drive. I'll click yes, and you have to give it permissions to run. And after a little bit, mine took a while, but it might happen right away for you. You're going to get a new menu and it will say sidebar. If you left click on that, and then you get the option to pop sidebar up on the right hand side. And this will give you a selection of choices that's populated from the worksheet that's called validation. So you can change the choices if you want. And we'll come over back to sheet one and we'll try this. And there you go. And so you can see it has a little added feature where it's counting the number of instances of each value. So that may be helpful for you as well. I just left it on there. That's the way the spreadsheet comes. So that's the first option. And if that's what you want, then you're done. You don't need anything more. These second two options are going to present other original ways to do it. Since there's no native option for a dropdown in Google Sheets, this is going to be workaround number two. And this one is going to be extremely important. It is going to contain sensitive information. It will be today's lunch order. What we'll do is we'll go to insert and choose form. And what this will do, this will make a Google form. And this Google form, since you created it from Sheets, is already linked to that sheet. And these responses are going to flow into it. So for the first question, it's just going to be name. That's going to be a short answer. Google Forms is smart enough where it knows that if you just want a name, it's a short answer. So we're going to keep that. Let's go over to the plus sign, left click on it to get another question. Now it's going to be toppings. All right, so let's take a minute to look at these different question types. And the short answer in the paragraph obviously aren't going to be what you want if you're looking for multiple selections. Multiple choice, you may think it is, but the little hint here is that it's a radio button, and those on the web usually mean that only one of the options can be selected. We'll skip down because next one's our answer. Dropdown only allows one in this circumstance. So let's go back up. Let's use checkboxes. And when you use checkboxes, you're going to see that you can select more than one. And then you may want to choose some pickles. You may, I probably want it, but hey, you never know. And then our last choice here, you can see there's in blue, an option that's called add other. And this other is a smart type of other, will allow you to type in a custom value. So not only are you going to be allowing multiple options, you're also going to be allowing a wildcard in this circumstance. You don't have to do that, but that was a neat thing to show you. Here we'll do a drop down. You'll see that this only allows you to choose one. We'll say type of bread or rye. We're not even going to give you the option for white bread today. Rye bread. Now let's view this form as if it's been published. So what you would do, you would create this form and then you would send it out to the people who are going to be using the spreadsheet. You can just send it as a link or you can email it. Lots of different options here. If you do want to learn more about Google Forms, I'll link to another video where you can learn about that right now. But really, we have this form built out enough where we're just ready to take a look at it. So let's cancel this. We're not going to actually send it. We're going to preview it, which is what you'd be seeing if you got it. And here you go. Here's your lunch order. Okay, so we're still in Google Forms, but this is connected to Sheets. So let's say Adam. And we'll come down to the toppings. Now, wait for it, because we want mustard and we want ketchup. And then if we do the drop down, you can see you can only choose one of these two options. We'll left click on whole wheat. The drop down goes away. I didn't even have a chance to try to hold down the control key and select more than one. It just lets you select one and click submit. And there you go. It took your lunch order. Let's go back to the sheet that it's linked to. It created a new tab, so we'll select that down the bottom by left-clicking on it. And the form responses came in here. It time-stamped it. You can ignore that for now. But it just took the values that we put into Google Forms. So it took my name, which was in a text box. But here's what we're looking for. So this was multiple selections. I could have just gotten mustard, just ketchup. I could have done nothing. And this whole wheat is just a regular drop-down. This is option number two as a workaround, since you can't do a multiple select drop-down, to give your spreadsheet users multiple options to choose from. Now, the third alternative that we're going to go through is truly an alternative, because we're actually going to move out of Google Sheets, because I just wanted to show you that there are some other programs out there that work a lot like spreadsheets, but they have more flexible data types and they actually have multi-select drop-down lists built in. So we'll open up a new tab. I've been playing around with something called Notion, so we're going to bring that up. There's other options out there, and I'll link to those in the description. But this particular one, you can see I've been using to try to get my website a little bit faster. Sort of working, but because I'm a spreadsheet guy, I tend to use these as spreadsheets, even though they're actually database tables. They're not spreadsheets, but you can use them in a similar way. What we're going to do, we're going to just create a new page. We'll go over to the left and you can choose if you want to share this with other people. You might just put it in your workspace. Don't put it in private because you can't share that. Left click on the plus sign. We're going to add a page. We're going to call it, and let's do lunch order again, right? Let's stay with that. It was working. And Notion has a lot of flexibility, so you can do more than tables with it. So you actually have to specify that this is going to be a table database. Left click on that. And we're in familiar territory here. You see a grid, you see headers. Now keep in mind, this is a database, so there's only one row where your headers can go and they can't move around. But this one says name, we're going to keep it like that. And you'll see that the property type is a title already. We're going to leave it as that. But then this one that's called tags, we're going to say toppings. And it's actually already set to a multi-select because it was called tags, so it's going to set up to take tags, but it's going to work for our toppings as well. There's other data types you could have here, but we can go into those in later videos. We're going to use a multi-select right now so you can see how it works. I'll left click out of there because I'm done with that one. And this one we were calling type of bread. And this is set as a files and media file type, which does not exist in Google Sheets, by the way, but we'll just make this a regular select instead of a multi-select. So your name is George, maybe? I don't know, I'm taking a shot in the dark. And the toppings that you want are mustard. Okay, so what's happening here is it's saying you're typing something new here. So do you want to create this label? It knows that it's not a pre-existing selection. So we'll actually go through and we'll do another one and see how it acts once you've done this. But we'll select mustard for now, and then we will also do mayo. Left click on mayo. So now you see both selections, they're both in here. Let's just do, and let's go to the next cell for now. We're going to do wheat bread. Create. And so that's a single select. You see it already kicked me out of the edit mode because it's not waiting for another one. So it's designed to know that this is going to be only one choice. Now, now Mary comes in. She wants to start with ketchup. All right, knows that doesn't exist, so let's left click on it. But then let's select from one of these existing ones. So let's also do mustard. You can do third one if you want. She does want that, so let's go over. We can only choose one of these. She wants rye. Let's give her that one. Now let's do a third one just to show that you can, Let's do a third one just to show that you can also select nothing if you're, you know, picky eater. This is Hayward, and he doesn't want anything, and he wants wheat bread. So you can just leave this empty. It doesn't give you any type of error. Now, this is similar to Google Sheets in that now you can share this if you want. It has all different types of sharing controls. You could add formulas in here if you really want to add up your sandwich. But just for the basics that I wanted to show you is that you can do multi-select dropdowns in a web application. It's just not Google Sheets. So we're all working in different situations, but hopefully one of these three solutions will fit what you're trying to do. And if you want to learn more about Google Forms, I put up a playlist in the upper right-hand corner where you can check out other videos on that subject. Thanks.